gonna see my actual bra. But I'm live now on Periscope, so then if I refresh my egg drop, you'll see the screen changes. So the egg bot is gonna go into my Periscope here momentarily. Oh, hang on, my name's not on there. / Femme Yoga Taylor. And yes, okay, so the egg bot just came in. Hey Klopnoff, hey Adrian, what's up? What's up? I'm teaching my mom how to use egg drops.
Oh my god, I gotta go get Dan, I forgot.
Oh my god! Okay, bye.
Okay.
Hello. Never mind, I'm not actually teaching my mom how to use egg drop because she forgot to go pick up my stepdad and he's waiting for her, so she just left. But what's everybody up to today? Scissors? Oh, they're over there by the base of the stairs. Hello, Felix DeGatto. I have tiny scissors. And that. Okay. Hello, what is that name? Ed Dog? Is my connection okay? Or is it freaking out? I feel like I've had bad luck. Hello, Eggbot. Hey, Klopnoff, yesterday I got Eggbot, just Eggbot. It was at Eggbot. There was no number after. It was pretty sweet. I thought it was pretty cool. Actually, I was just putting makeup on. I have to leave in a little while. What time is it? Oh, no, I have lots of time. What up, everybody? R14s. Looking for mascara in my purse. What's today, Tuesday? What's everyone up to on this Tuesday? Oh, my cat's coming up. He knows I'm live. You guys can't really see him, but he's here. Oh my gosh. All right, let me angle this a little bit so you can see him. Oh, John has Eggbot today. That's cool. Do you see the cat? He just flopped up here and put his head on my lap like a pillow.
I was just asking where he was. Now we know.
He's been sleeping all day, and then he just came out of bed and was like, oh, I need to sleep more. I'm really tired. Oh my gosh. I was working in the other bedroom today, so he was really excited. Both the cats were like, what? This bedroom's open. And then he went in. Bella Gatto, beautiful cat. Yes, thank you. He's a boy, so he's handsome. What's handsome in Italian? Jack loves Periscope.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Pat. Hey, Nikki. What's up, Nikki? I'm like darkness. You can't even see me, can you? I'm just nothing. I don't know what to do about it. Why don't we just, like, angle it to be just the cat, then?
Because of the bright background.
Cat Scope, the trilogy.
Fu Manchu cat.
Yeah, Bella doesn't really work on a boy. Do you know the Italian word for handsome? Would you call him Fu Manchu?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean?
Like Asian warrior.
Felicia, hello. I was teaching my mom how to use egg drop, but she had to go, so now it's just Cat Scope the trilogy. He heard me periscoping and he came downstairs and was like, I'm gonna get in on this. And he laid his head on my lap. I should have hashtagged it Cat Scope. I didn't know it was about to happen. He's purring. You're trying to think of something. Why don't you just use your hacker's keyboard? You know what? I think Google will know. Oh, my hair's tickling him. Okay. Oh, translate. Handsome to Italian. Oh, it's just Bello. Now we know. He's Bello. Bello Gatto. Hello there. I can't read exactly what that says, but it looks like Roger, I think. Translate Bello. Does it do hashtag translate? I don't think so. Wow, big cat. Yeah. Big lazy cat. Do you want to see his mouth? That's his little black freckle he has on his lip. Cat is sitting with mouse. Yes, this happens a lot. I love the pun. I've used the pun many times. Now my husband is helping with filming. Different cat angles. It looks perfect.
That tickle him. No.
People are laughing. They're like, what? I was teaching my mom how to use egg drop, and now I'm petting my cat. What's up, everyone? Where's everyone tuning in from? Oh, actually, you guys, Felicia, Klopnoff. I don't know if there's anybody else in here that I know. I don't know if Nikki's still here, probably. I got an email today from Periscope TV. They're starting a new group of wellness coaches. They're calling it cohorts, C-O-H-O-R-T-S. His tongue looks even better. Can you see his tongue? It smells good.
He's a very clean cat.
He is very clean. He's got very white feet. Hello, your husband, says Felicia.
Hello.
What was I just talking about?
Talking about how clean Jack is.
No, I wasn't. Okay, some random person. The first time I've ever been in here. Your husband is showing us his butthole. I'm trying to eat. Oh, you mean the cat's butthole? I was going to block him because I thought he meant your own butthole.
My butthole's not that hairy.
But you don't like that, sir? Oh, he pulled it down.
Now he's self-conscious.
Yeah.
Am I not aiming it right?
No, I think you're aiming it fine. Hey, un gato bellissimo.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful, beautiful cat. Oh yeah, the cohorts. So they're starting a new group of cohorts. So it's going to be around 20 different broadcasters, and we're going to be doing different scopes on health and wellness, and we'll be promoting each other's broadcasts from each other's. So I'm really excited about that. So I was invited to join that, as well as Danique, my best friend, Yardi Yogini. If you're not following her, go follow her. I'm following her. You can check her on my list. I don't think she's in here right now. But she was also invited to join, so we're going to be doing some different health and yoga and wellness scopes. She also does scopes for natural hair, so she got some natural hair products just today. I think she's going to do some natural hair scopes. And hey, your cat is trying to Illinois me to sleep. I don't really know what that means. He didn't like it. He did not like that joke. What does it mean to Illinois someone? Is Illinois boring, so you're boring them to sleep? Or is it like, he looks so peaceful and comfortable, now you want to sleep?
That's what happens to me.
Show. Show what? It's my cat. Block. Hello. Hello, Shutter Speed. What's everybody doing today? Aw, I know, right? I was doing a broadcast about how I was teaching my mom to use egg drop, but then she left and my cat jumped up, so they're from Illinois, I guess? Maybe. That means he's trying to get to sleep. Okay. You have two? I have two cats, too. We have two cats. My husband's actually holding the camera. My cat was hooked on catnip. Now he's in a 12-step program. Okay, okay. Why does my cat scope always get so many people?
Because Jack has the power.
My cat is so much more popular than me, you guys. Actually, my yoga scope still holds the record, but the record for my cat scopes was 222. Yeah, they both go outside. They go outside all the time.
Especially this one.
Especially this one, yeah. He tromps around in the really tall snow. We live in New York, so he doesn't even care if it's snowing. My cat died, so I got it stuffed so I can sleep next to her. Okay, sweet Lou. No judgment here. This cat's wicked soft.
We were thinking about a scarf.
Yeah, I think this cat would make a pretty nice garment. That one got a heart. Thanks for the hearts. I'm glad you guys have morbid humor like we do. You're afraid to let yours out? What are you afraid of?
Depends on where you live, I guess.
Do they have their claws, your cats? Hello, Brandon. I don't know who that is. I'll just say hi to everyone. Or they were trying to annoy, but autocorrect got the better of them and changed it to Illinois. Perhaps.
Yep. That explains a lot. It wasn't autocorrect, it was voice to text, maybe.
No, he explained it. The person who said it already answered, but he said that it means that he's trying to get to sleep. I just said, okay.
He's always asleep.
It was probably was an autocorrect thing. I don't think it was supposed to say annoy, though. Maybe lol? Lol? Mm. That could come out Illinois. What do you think about people who eat cats? Can't knock it till you try it. Just kidding. I guess I don't think about people who eat cats.
That's a good point, though.
But I do make jokes all the time about eating this cat, because he's meaty and delicious. He's purring. He likes it. See you guys? Hey again. Who's here? Oh, hello, Peter. How are you? Welcome, welcome. We met playing Hangman yesterday. They are cat eaters? Wait, who's a cat eater? The person who said that? He does have a lot of meat. His name is Jack. Oh, what do you think of people who eat cats? They're cat eaters. Okay, I get it. Do I have much to do today? Actually, I'm leaving in a little while to go to a wake, and then earlier I did that business call that I scoped about afterwards. But not a ton to do after that, just some work, some normal work, nothing too crazy. Tuesdays can be a little bit of a busy day, but oh my gosh, so many hearts. How do you send the hearts that fast, Felicia? It's amazing. I love it. See, I don't see any winter hearts, though, Klopnoff. Is anything coming up on your screen? I tried using winter, but I don't see any weird hearts coming up. Okay, what did I miss?
Oh, is this a shattered phone?
Yes. I'm broadcasting from New York. But I'm awake. That sounds fun. Okay, I guess. What was the joke I was just gonna say? Oh. How does it go? I don't remember. It's something to do with the ba-dum bum ch, but I don't remember how it goes, so that was a pretty bad joke, I'd say. Oh, okay, here's a joke. Where do cows go on dates? Hello, Babby Amek. The movies. I like that one. Cute cat is covering face. Yes, he is. He's a little shy today. I like that I have a cameraman that doesn't charge me anything. Bada bing. Yeah, that was a good one. I like cheesy, corny jokes. Oh, here's one. How do you find Will Smith in the snow? I'm already laughing at you. Does anyone know? How do you find Will Smith in the snow? You're from Turkey? Hello, welcome from Turkey. Is that your name, Bobby Yamik, or is there a different name here? Is it Enes? Enes? Is that your name? Enes from Turkey? That's cool. That's pretty. Welcome. Yeah, I know what the badumch was for. Hey, Dr. John. What's up? My cat is being more popular than me, as always. What's good? Your name is Anas. Welcome, Anas. You have pretty good English. You speak good English, much better than my Turkish. That is for sure. Are you male or female? Nice cat. Thank you. Thank you very much. I work really hard.
We grew him.
Will Smith. Oh, yeah. So how do you find Will Smith in the snow? Dr. John just got here. We'll give him a chance to guess if he knows any kind of jokes. How do you find Will Smith in the snow, you guys? Answer coming to you live in 5, 4, 3, 2. He says he doesn't know. 1, 0. Hard to compete with a cat like that. That's true. I think you're right. So, how do you find Will Smith in the snow? You look for the fresh prints.
I thought it was going somewhere else, but I'm glad it didn't.
I love puns, he says. I love jokes. What other jokes do we know? That's like the only joke I ever remember. Mamash? What is mamash? Mama. When I translate mamash, it comes out mama. Me too, I thought it was going to be racist. Someone said, no, never. Yeah, Dr. John, tell us about hashtag winter. Our hearts aren't doing anything fun. Klopnoff told me to try it, but I don't know if it works or not.
Mandatory union lunch break.
Aww. Guys, my cameraman is leaving. It's expired? Oh, okay, good to know. It worked last year, yeah. Yeah, I feel like Easter egg is like kind of early, but maybe not. Hello, everyone. Hello, Dank Chef. Did I have another live before this? Yeah, I did a... Well, you were in the other live. No, I don't think... I think I did a really short one, but I'm gonna delete that one because it didn't really work. The audio wasn't working. Hi, Jake. See you later, Enes. Nice to meet you. Be right back? Okay. That works for me. Back to the coal mines. Do you really work in a coal mine? That is pretty cool. Well, have a good day, Peter. Bye. Hope Jack got to cheer up your day a little bit. Brighten it up. Just a saying. That's what I figured. Well, don't forget to whistle while you work. I know, he has such a good life. He doesn't have to do anything. He just sleeps all day. And he makes me really famous on Periscope. And I like that. I like fame and fortune from cat love. You'd want to come back as a house cat? Yeah, as long as you're in a good house, though. Because some house cats have a really bad life. Like, if this cat couldn't go outside, I don't think he would like that very much. I don't know how to best stabilize this. Yeah, the Easter egg is not really related to Easter. It's like, oh, are those computers? I thought they were refrigerators. Yeah, our house is pretty awesome. I don't know if you guys were watching the business talk earlier when I was scoping outside and he jumped up on the banister. He like hangs off over the edge of a cliff. He's pretty badass.
Jack did that.
He has no fear.
Oh my God.
He does it all the time.
He jumped? You say he jumped?
No, he jumped up onto it. While I was scoping, like right next to me, I was scoping, and then he was like, I'm here, and he jumped up. A big guy like him, yes. Oh, he's clicking things. Can we play Hangman? Yeah, you guys can play Hangman. I'm down with that. It's Ash Wednesday now. Today's Tuesday.
Maybe they're in, like, Australia.
He's in Denmark. Yeah, he is playing with the mouse.
He's on the other side of the...
No, that's like Australia.
It is? I thought it was... What time is it in Denmark?
What time is it in Denmark, Klopnoff? Let me guess.
Let me guess on Google.
It's 10:19. No, I was just looking at the time. I bet it's 10:19. Is it 10:19? Or actually, you wouldn't call it 10:19. What would you call it? You'd call it like 22:19. Is it 22:19 there? Denmark has the same time as we. It's 6 hours later, right? Yeah, you missed the business talk, Jake. It was pretty good. You love puns. Okay, bye. Oh, yeah, because the cat and the mouse. Okay, bye. Here it is Wednesday already. If you consider sunset the separator. Sunset? Sunset is not separator. Yes. Yeah, it's only 10:22 at night. You still got another hour and a half before it's tomorrow. Whew, my face is real close to the... Oh, he's grabbing it. Oh, what did you miss in the business talk? So I had a business call, and I was talking about how, I think, I talked about the book The E-Myth, which is actually right here, might be upside down, but The E-Myth Revisited. I talked about that in the three different personality types that all entrepreneurs have, and I was talking about how when you're starting up a business, it can be difficult because, oh, sunset used to be the separator? Interesting, I didn't know that. What about like Alaska when the sun never sets, or when the sun always never rises?
Time doesn't change.
All right, so everyone's really young in Alaska. Perfect. And Antarctica. So we talked about the three different personality types, which was entrepreneur, manager, and technician. And we talked about how when you're starting up a startup and you have a new product and a new offer, you have to always be crafting it to what customers actually want to buy, as opposed to what you think they should want and what you think that they're going to want. You know, it's like I got off the call and it was like, why doesn't anyone want exactly what I want to give to them? They want their like modified, customized, personalized version of something. It just seems to me like it's not as useful or efficient to get the results they want to get. And it's just kind of, who is my cat entrepreneur? What? My cat's name is Jack, not entrepreneur. I'm the entrepreneur. He's the worker bee. This is my personal assistant. He's what?
Mascot.
Yeah, he's the mascot and the personal assistant. And he's got a really warm belly, so if your hands are cold, he's the official hand warmer. You just put it right in there and try to stay very still. Hello, Glypine. Glypine, that's pretty. We're just hanging out with my cat, talking business, talking books, talking egg drop, talking relationships. My husband's here. You guys want to ask him anything? Did you guys see my roof scope last night? I know Jake was there. Jake came into my roof scope, and then I did another roof scope because I went back up, and he came into that one. And then he left because he got bored, and he came back, and I was still up there. Because I'm a doer. And because of Bobby helping us. Aya Pot says, how'd you meet your wife?
I was at a party at my cousin's, which is good because I almost never come out of my hole.
Should I point it at you? They always see this. I show them our house all the time. It's Cornell, you guys. It's Cornell. Guess it. Okay. So how'd you meet me?
I was at a party at my cousin's, and I was hanging out and having a good time, drinking beer, being unhealthy, but luckily, beer makes me not so shy. So I would, you know, more likely to talk to a pretty young girl. She's 10 years younger than me, so pretty much can't go wrong there, huh? Plus, she happens to be really smart and beautiful, so.
Aww.
Man, well, lucky. I owe my cousin big time for inviting her.
Ah.
And then I had to fight over my with my other cousin over her.
Awkward.
That happened.
Martin says, cool Les Paul. And then Jake said, what kind of guitar does he have?
It is a Gibson Les Paul Studio. I just got it like 2 or 3 days ago. And, I have a Epiphone Les Paul, so I've been playing on that for a long time. So I really wanted to see if there was a difference between the Gibson and the Epiphone. And I would say for sure, man, in terms of these pickups, huge difference. No surprise there, but it sounds so much, there's so much more clarity if you, you know, hit a chord when you're plugged in. And if it's like a high gain situation, the Epiphone kind of turns to mud, where this thing stays clear, but also it's like clarity with high gain, which is really a nice, it's pleasing to the human ear. That's why they're so popular. It just sounds right to the human ear for some reason, and actually to cat ears. Surprisingly, my cat doesn't run away when I jam out. Actually, he seems to be attracted by it, actually.
Yeah, I love listening to you play, so do the cats. So Klopnoff said, Baruch Hashem, which I forget what that means, but I feel like it means peace, perhaps? Peace? Martin, tell us what that means, Baruch Hashem. Wait, can I translate it? No. I translate it and say it's the same, Baruch Hashem. And then Jake said, full fisticuffs. Do you know what that means?
Fisticuffs?
Fisticuffs? Fisticuffs? I don't know what that means. Okay.
I probably should know.
And then he asked you, what music does he play?
Oh, I like Black Sabbath and Tool. And pretty much any like classic rock and rock is really fun to play on a Les Paul. And I have a terrible memory, so it's a lot of hard work to memorize tabs. But if the solo is really good, I'll play the solo and memorize that. And that's just a ton of fun for me. So I probably know a bunch of solos. I don't know much about chords. I can't read music. I'm a drummer, so I read drum music, not notes. So. I've been noodling around on guitar since I was 13, so that's a lot of years of just screwing around and not learning how to play properly. But it's all right if you're having fun, who cares?
If I'm going to play in a band, I'd play the drums, not the guitar. I just, like, I'm a wannabe guitar player, you could say.
I think you're a good guitar player.
Thank
and he
you,
says, Jake says, and what does he play through? Marshall Stack?
Well, I'm a little embarrassed to admit it, but I don't have an amp. I actually plug into a black coffee distortion box, and I plug that right into a stereo receiver because I'm a stereo nerd, and I always have really good speakers and subwoofers, and to be honest, it sounds fantastic hooked up to a home stereo. Just sounds phenomenal. And the subwoofer, you can kind of dial in the bass to make it just right, and the speakers have awesome clarity. Whereas an amp, generally speaking, they're designed to play loud. Not to say that these aren't loud, but the amp doesn't have tweeters, and it doesn't really have a subwoofer. And even if you do hook up a subwoofer, they don't usually hit low. So it's actually a lot of fun to play through home stereo. And I really want to get like a nice effects pedal, like a fuzz box, or like a one that has some really cool like old school transistors, like germanium. Something that gives a real cool fuzz sound. That's probably going to be my next investment rather than buying an amp. I'm looking at one on eBay. It's like $140. Has crazy fuzz sounds. Almost sounds like Nintendo sometimes. I can't think of the name off the top of my head, though.
That's cool. I just started following a producer on here yesterday with some pretty good music. I forget his name, otherwise I give him a shout-out. Klopnoff, you said Shalom is peace, and I know that, but what's Baruch Hashem? What's what you said? And then Jake said, fighting with his cousin, dot, dot, dot.
Oh, fisticuffs, yeah.
Oh.
No, luckily we didn't come to blows. But
oh.
Yeah. No, it was just a matter of... he thought I was, like, trying to secretly steal her away, and I was like, oh, man, I think that you actually found him to be a little abrasive or something, and I wasn't going to say that to him, so I just was trying not to hurt his feelings, and he thought I was being a sneak.
No, I pursued you, really. I added you on Facebook.
She added me on Facebook. That's a big part of the story. Facebook love affair.
It was a Facebook love affair.
Well, it's like, yeah, it's like a modern way to, like, contact somebody. It was, you know, very
yes.
grateful I was on Facebook.
Klopnoff, that did work. It said the Spirit of God.
And what language is it using?
Hebrew. That was Hebrew, what he
cool.
just said.
That's old language, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, super old. One of the, is it the oldest? I'm not positive. No, I don't think it's the oldest, but it's very old.
And now, is it true that Hebrew is like, is Jewish, like, Bibles written in Hebrew? Is that right? Like, old Bibles?
Like the Torah. I know the Torah is definitely written in Hebrew, but I think there's a lot of Bibles written in all different languages.
Greek and stuff, probably, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Jake says he plays a Fender.
What kind of Fender?
What kind of Fender, Jake? I want specifics. He said, I picked up a Rat clone cheap off eBay not too long ago. That sounds okay. And he said it's a Strat.
Nice. I think that I just heard about them. They're made... Did you say Rat?
He said, I picked up a Rat clone. I don't know. Oh, I think he meant to say Strat, actually.
Strat clone. Okay,
yeah,
that's
okay.
It was a Rat pedal. That's why I was wondering if he was talking about that.
Oh, okay.
That no. Yeah, I think I was just watching a video on YouTube the other day. They were talking about how there's like three major manufacturers in Asia that make a lot of the guitars, and some of them are actually pretty darn good. And I think Squire is made by two of them. So I don't know which one. If you get a Squire... And there's a made in Mexico Stratocaster, like, very well respected. If you put good parts in it, they say it's just as good as an American one.
He said, it's the pedal rat 2.
Yep.
Oh, okay. So Klopnoff says, I think Hebrew is the oldest, but some say it comes partly from Egyptian. Talk to Aaron about that. Who's Aaron? Do I know Aaron? I'm looking it up. That's old language. Whoop. Oh, yeah. I should probably leave soon.
Where are you going?
To Nina's wake. What's the oldest. Are you getting hearts for you?
Yes, it's hearts.
Yay! Is it Felicia? But it's Felicia.
It's blue hearts.
Yeah, it's Felicia. Felicia, you just broke 1,000 hearts. You're winning. I was just about to announce that too, but then you just broke 1,000, so it's even more perfect.
And where's Felicia from?
Aaron Tour Guide. Is he a Periscope person? I'm going to look him up. Felicia is in Sweden. She has a really, really cool accent. Actually, I think you saw me watching her thing yesterday.
I did. I love Swedish accents. It's so cool. Americans love Swedish accents, just so you guys know. Actually, we love just about all accents as well.
Yeah, that's true. We even love like our own like Southern accents and stuff.
Yeah, it can be like, Southern accent can be charming.
Oh, look,
Australian,
Jake,
New Zealand.
Jake recognized the song you were playing. He said, that's Tool, I think.
Yeah, he, good call, man. That's like one of my favorite solos. Just can't get enough of that one. I mean, that's my ringtone, put it that way.
Oh, yeah, I know that one pretty well. What's the name of it?
Parabola.
Yes.
The name of the song. I get mixed up sometimes with Tool names. I was going to say Lateralus, but that's not right.
Aaron Shafir. I'm adding him right now. He's also a scribe. Cool.
Hello.
Hello, the black cat who came. That's what Felicia said. Felicia, you could see Macy?
She walked by.
Oh, she walked by? I didn't even see her walk by.
I cleaned up her landing.
Oh, thank you, babe. I feel like I clean it up every morning, but it still gets crazy.
Two or three times a day is all it
Oh,
is.
You missed the cat? Don't worry. There's your chance. She's flopped out over there.
Oh, that's not a cat.
In her normal
that's,
spot.
That's a raccoon.
It is a raccoon. Someone said that in yoga the other morning.
Jack's being a rabbit right now. Or a possum? He's like a possum rabbit.
Alright, how do I follow this guy? Hang on, what's everybody saying? I missed it. Yeah, Jake said you should plug in sometime in Scope.
It's embarrassing. I have to learn how to play first. That's probably the first thing. No, I just cop. I like to play some of my own tunes, but I just love the sound and the mechanics, you know? Just goofing around, but I can't actually play songs from start to finish. So, it's for my own entertainment. But I have a couple of guitars. I do have a Fender Strat, and I love Jimi Hendrix, so gotta have a Fender Strat. Beautiful, sounds fantastic. I bought it off of a friend to kind of just hang on to because I didn't have any like quote unquote real guitars that were supposedly set up like to really be right. So I didn't even know what low action means. I didn't know what, you know, how much like weird sounds come out of your G string. If you whack it, sometimes it'll have this weird ringing sound, especially on a G and stuff like that. I just wanted to know what's a right guitar sound like, so I have something to compare it to, so I can see is my Epiphone out of whack. I have a PRS SE245, which is I think it's like the World Music Instruments made in Korea, a really good factory. And I was wondering if it's set up right because somebody had changed the nut, they changed out the pickups. I wasn't sure how much bend should really be in the neck. You don't really know until you see it done right. So that's why I got the American Fender. And I got used to playing that, so I knew what to look for. And then I tried to get the guitars all set up so they have a reasonably low action. As you guys can see, I'm playing unplugged all the time. So if the thing is buzzing like crazy when it's unplugged, but it sounds great when it's plugged in, that's a no-go. So I really want to get into like working on frets. You know, leveling or redressing frets and stuff like that. That'll be something coming up because the way I play, I'm always bending notes and I wear out the frets on cheap guitars. Supposedly, the more expensive guitars have harder stainless steel that doesn't wear as easily, which is a good thing. But if you go in there and just dress those up a little bit, get rid of the flat spots, it should reduce some of the buzzing on the cheaper guitars. So I gotta get into that a little bit. Love the PRS though.
So Klopnoff said, cool. And he said, he can make a group. Felicia left. She's like, this is boy stuff. Klopnoff said, oh no, she's back. He can make a group for friends and scope just for them, but do not ask me how. I know how to do that. So if you ever want to do that, I do that. You can scope to like just your followers, or you can make a group of just a few people who can see you if you want.
That would be fun to just scope, man.
I always feel like it's more fun with, or it's like it's less intimidating with strangers than it is with people you actually know.
Probably learn a lot too.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Well, people will be real honest.
Yeah.
You suck. You're like,
oh. There's always a lot to be gained. I've been playing with my pedal turned up too high, and I didn't know. I was was getting so much mud until I turned it down a little and like tried to get that clarity with the better pickups and stuff. And it's like, wow, what a nice difference. You know, I've been playing like that for years, not realizing that. So little things like that, you know, I pick up on places like YouTube, and just having some outside input goes a long way.
Yeah. Felicia said it's private, and I think she's talking about the group, which I can show you how to do if you ever want. And then Jake said, do you set it up yourself?
Yeah. I adjust the action and the intonation myself. I can adjust the truss rods and stuff. I like to give just a teensy tiny little bit of relief in the truss rod so you can see just a very slight bend forward. Because I play unplugged a lot, I need a little extra distance to, you know, cut down on fret buzz.
Wait, which way? This way? There we go. I just want to make sure Macy's in the picture.
And you can adjust the height of your bridge and your truss rod to try to get that action where you want it. And then, you know, on this guitar, you can adjust intonation so that you have nice clean notes here and your open string and it matches. And then you just kind of make that compromise when you're tuning. But I have some guitars where, like my PRS has a hard stop tail, you can't adjust intonation. So if you put like unusual size strings, or if you raise up the height of your bridge or anything like that, it can throw your intonation off permanently in that guitar. So that's not a great thing, but the guitar is phenomenal because the guy who I bought it from had put some nice pickups in. He put DiMarzio PAF and a DiMarzio Super Distortion. And I went online and checked those out, and they're probably a pretty nice improvement over the stock PRS SE245 pickups. And they do sound really good. They don't go to mud when you go with high gain. So I appreciate the fact that they put those in there. Definitely a fun thing to play with. So, yeah, maybe the intonation is not perfect. So I'd almost rather tune it on the 12th fret than an open string, because most of the stuff I play is in this zone anyways. But I'm still experimenting with different strings. You know, I got 9s and 10s, and I can't decide what I like better. So I got to keep experimenting.
So, Nikki came back and left. So, Jake said, yeah, it depends on what kind of day the observers are having. Sometimes they just want to ruin your day. And then Felicia says, I've been in the USA when I was little, and of course I want to go back. It was so long. It was such a long time back. And then Klopnoff said, you should visit Taylor's Cats then. They are so cool. And then Jake said, Tone-O-Matic is pretty nice. I have a cheap Epiphone without it, and it is just crap to play. And then Felicia's asking Klopnoff if he's been to the United States. And she said, of course I would visit Taylor then. You better, girl. You better come visit me. I want to come to Sweden and visit you, too. I'll race you. We'll see who leaves the country first. You should come back to the USA. Okay, actually, on this note, because I don't really see any other questions, say bye to my sexy husband. Okay, so the Adirondacks are pretty sweet. Yeah, they are pretty sweet. So we got cat party here. I'm going to log off now so I can go over to this wake and get the rest of my day going. So it was good to talk to all of you. It's always so good to see y'all. I love connecting on here, and let me know.
He's doing a pose for him.
I know. It's mostly just him right now. Yeah, Klopnoff has not been to the United States. Well, you're invited. You can come visit us, too. It'll be fun. All right. Bye, everyone. God bless everyone. That's what Klopnoff said. Wait, I don't want the cat in there.